Now we have several type of special constants available in a Scilab. So we can use these particular constants for our numerical computation. For example, as we know, for a complex variable, we require a real part and a imaginary part. So for representation of imaginary part, we require iota terms, and we can easily represent iota by percent I, and it simply represents square root of I. Similarly, we have a pi value which is equals to 3.14, and if we want to directly use a pi, we can simply use percentage pi. Likewise, we have a percentage E whose value is 2.718. likewise, we have a percent epsilon which represent a precision of a machine, so that if we have how small a number our machine can compute. Next, we have a NaN, which is representing not a number. Suppose in our table, if we do not have a data in some specific location, or we have a missing data in our table, then we represent it as a not a number. Likewise, we have a infinity, and we have a percentage T and percentage F, which representing a true, or it returns a value 1, and for false it returns a value 0. So we see all these things in a Scilab practical session. Okay, so first, for creation of any variable, I have to simply type a name of a variable. Let us suppose I am simply writing P over here, and I am assigning a value 4 to this P. So you can see, after pressing enter, this variable browser is now pop out with a value P and whose value is 4. Since I have not defined any data type over here, by default the type is double. Suppose if I want to make it some specific data type, let us suppose I want to make it to a integer 16, then I have to simply write what P equals to int 16, and then the value of a variable P. Value of variable P is 4, or I will change the name of variable to Q so that we can easily differentiate. So you can see over here, now the variable Q is pop out over here in variable browser, and now the type is changed to integer 16, and the visibility is local. Local means the scope it is representing over here. We will discuss about this local and global variable in scripts and function chapter. Similarly, we can easily create a string. Let us suppose I am creating one more variable, and I am saving some string value in that. So for saving a string value, we can either use a single quote or a double quote. Let us suppose I am simply writing a good over here. So now the value of variable s is good, and the type is string. We can also add string a string in that particular variable s. Suppose I am writing morning. So you can see we have a good morning present over here in a console. Now one thing you have to check, since here I have created one variable s, and I have assigned a value good in that particular variable s, but here I have simply write s plus morning. So we have a good morning, and we haven't assigned any variable over here. So by default we have a answer variable present over here, and its value is now good morning. So this by default variable is now pop out over here in variable browser, and again its type is string. So whenever you write some value and you haven't assigned that particular value to any variable, so by default it assigned to a answer variable. As you can see over here, I have simply typed 5 and press enter, so now the default answer variable is changed to 5 and its type is changed to double. As you can see over here, we have a number of variables present and we have a command history over here. And if I want to clear all the variables, so I simply write a command clear. So this clear command will clear all the variables present over here in a variable browser. Similarly, if I want to clear the console, if we have a lots of command present over here in a console and I want to clear this particular console, so I have to type clc, which represents clear console, and if I press enter, we get my console to be clear. Now we are going to see special constants, then we will check out the complex variable definition. Basically, special constants, as I have already told you, that we can directly use. Suppose if I want to check a value of pi, so we know that the value of pi is 22/7 or 3.14. So if I want to use that particular value directly for our numerical computation, so we can use it by making by typing percentage pi. So its value is 3.14. Likewise, I can also get a value of I. So you can see we have a 0 plus I, which representing a complex number. So we do not have any real number. That's why it is showing 0 over here plus I. So by default, it is considered as a I into 1. Similarly, if I want to check a value of E, so e to the power 1 is 2.718. So we get a value of E over here. Likewise, if I want to check a precision, so I simply type a percentage epsilon. So you can see the precision is 2.220 d to the power minus 16. So that much minimum value is possible in Scilab. Similarly, we have a NaN command, which representing not a number, and we have a infinite with percentage sign. So we have a infinite present over here, and percentage T is representing true value and percentage F is representing false value. So you can see we have a number of special constants available, and all those constants you can find in a Scilab manual, so you can directly use in your experiments or for any numerical computations. So for defining of a, again I am clearing my console, and now we are going to see how to define a complex numbers. So for defining of a complex number, as I have already told you, that we can simply use a iota symbol with percentage I. So let us suppose I have to write 2 plus 3i. I have to write 2 plus 3i. So I can simply write 2 plus percentage I multiply 3. So you can see we have a 2 plus 3i, which representing a complex number. Similarly, we can perform a different operations with a complex number. Let us suppose I have a number 2 plus 5, and I want to multiply that particular number with percentage I. I want to multiply 2 plus 5i with a 2i. So you can see we have an answer as minus 10 plus 4i. So as you can see, we can easily define a complex number, and we can also perform a various calculations with a complex number. Like if I want to calculate a value of sine, so I can simply write sine percentage pi divide 2, we get a value 1. Or if I want to get a value sine percentage pi divide 4, we get a value 1 by root 2, which is 0.707. Next, we are going to see how to make a variable constant. First, I am clearing my console. So we are going to see how to make a variable constant. Suppose, as you can see over here, I'm again defining one variable q and whose value is 1. Okay, so you can see we have a value of a variable as 1 and we have a type as double. And again, I am creating a variable q and I am changing its value to a integer and its value is 5. Now you can see the value of variable q is changed to integer 8 from double. So as you can see, whatever the value we are defining in our variable, it gets changed on that particular instance. So suppose if you are working on some experiment and you want your variable to get fixed so that its value does not get changed. So for that, you have to use a pre-def function. So if you want to make a variable constant, then you have to make use of a command pre-def. Okay, if I have used a pre-def and then in single quotes I am simply passing a variable name q,